Morning guys, welcome back to the channel, welcome back to another video, another day, yeah, another pickup day. Gonna head off over to Colchester this morning. We're gonna pick up another project because, like, you know, as you know about the white Corsa, we've got problems with paint on that one, which is being sorted at the minute, and he's gonna probably take, he reckons, give him a couple of days, he said, you know what I mean, just to get it sorted and whatever. Really appreciate all the comments, guys. You know, you are, most of you are right on what you're saying about taking the whole car to the painters and then they can just get it done and get it all sorted. The trouble is with doing that, is what I found, is that the car itself, if it's not completely road legal, it's got to be trailered or transported to the paint shop. Well, that's an extra cost. In the actual car. And so far, taking the parts to the painter, I've managed to sort of, yeah, get it done, and it's every car's gone out good. So, I don't know why, you know, this particular time, it's gone a bit pear-shaped for him. All he had to do was match the colour that I originally gave him. All I wanted him to do was repaint the parts that I gave him the same colour as what it was. I wasn't, you know what I mean? There wasn't new parts. Yeah, so that's... it's just one of them things. Anyway, when I can take the car to the... I can take that Corsa now because it's, you know, it's fully road legal. I've got a motor trade insurance, so I'm able to drive any vehicle. So that's all good. So when I can, I will take the vehicles to the paint shop. So I'm in the process of putting through application for motor trader, and getting some trade plates. So that's all going through the process at the minute because you can only sell so many cars per year before you've got to do that. So yeah, it's all coming together. It's all bits and pieces that I've got to sort out. So, yeah, listen, let's just dive into today's video. Let's go and pick up the next project so we've got something to work on. I'll see you soon, guys. So yes, guys, it's another Fiesta. Nice little red one, this one. It's a nice colour, I like this colour. It's a very girly colour, I think. Don't want to insult anyone, but I think it is a girly colour. I don't know if any boys are driving this colour. But yeah. So here we go. So this is a 2011 on a 60 plate. But it was registered registered in 2011, Ford Fiesta Z-Tech. So it's a 5-door, as you can see. Most of the damage is at the front, and you know, we'll have a walk around and have a look. I haven't really gotten through this car, to be honest with you. Everything is just left it as it is. I just dropped it off, and then yeah, we're gonna walk around it. So front end damage. First of all, the bonnet is okay. I believe I've checked it. The hinges line up okay with the pillar, both sides, so that hasn't really been touched and donked, I don't think. So that's good. I think the lights have. Let's actually open her up. That's better. We can see. So the lights have been tonged away from the bracket here, but that's easy repairable, so that light is going to be good to go. This one up here, there's a slight little fracture there, you can just see it there, so that's going to be repairable as well. Same with the other side, that repair that,
Don't know about that one. Might have to replace that one because it's gone down too far. Might have to replace that part there. But coolant's still in the tank, so radiators hasn't been touched or burst, so that's good. It's had a push. It's definitely had a push. I think this bar's gonna have to be replaced. Yeah, we'll replace that bar. Don't think the leg's been touched as such, don't think. But yeah, I'm gonna get it in anyway. I'm gonna strip the whole front off, you know what I mean? And just have a good look inside, what's going on, what's been damaged, what's been touched. But it's best definitely had a push, because you can tell by, obviously that should be then connected into that. But I've got a spare one of them anyway, so that's good. Yeah, other bits and pieces. Don't really know, like that's broken. You can see that the pump here snapped off here. So that's gonna need renewing. So I will get another one of them, because that's not gonna stay there. Don't think the wings have been touched. They ain't been dented at all. They look in good condition. No dents, few scratches, but normal stuff, wear and tear stuff, you know. Same as the other side. Oh, that's interesting. Wow, I've never seen that before. That is cool. So that's your proof of the timing belt changed, when it was changed, the date and the mileage. Wow, that is cool. That is good for the next owner. Very good. I'm liking that. Why don't everyone do that? Like, it's so much better. You can tell straight away then. Let's just put a sticker up there, write it on there. That's good. That's a good thing. So this wing's okay. It's not been scratched or dinked, dented, so that's good. As I said to you, the bonnet's good. That lines up both sides okay, and catches. It's just obviously the bumper, slam panel, that sort of thing. It needs a good clean really before I can start saying it needs, you know, this needs doing, that needs doing. It needs a good clean, because I'm thinking that that's a scratch and it's not. It's a bit of cobweb. So there's no point really me going through and letting you know about the outside, because it's just filthy. But this bumper needs doing as well, so you can see. It's had a dink there. It looks like it's been in a bloody like a hedge or something. So I'm gonna have to take this off, bumper, and we'll get that looked at. Maybe repair that, and then they can just do this corner, blow it in. We'll see. Some bits and pieces in here. That definitely needs replacing. Grill. Don't know about the fog light. Fog light looks busted as well, so I might just throw that. So that's good. Let's have a look underneath here. Got a decent, brand new spare wheel. So that's good. A few tools underneath there as well. But, you know, I'll have a good, I'll get all that out. When I take her in, I'll get all that underneath that and have a look at that. Nice car. Look at the inside. It's alright, just a bit dirty, scuffy. Nothing can be, nothing that can't be sorted out. No fag burns on the back seats. Pretty decent, yeah. I like it. It's nice, nice. Let's have a look at the front. Oh, I've got a book. I did notice that through the window, but I haven't really gone through it. So, let's have a quick look. Service history I'm looking for. Quick guide. No. Customer care. Might be in that. No. Protect your vehicle. No, not be that. It's not gonna be that either. And it's the manual.
that manual?
Yeah. So does it, oh, is it in the back there? I think it's gonna be in the back here, isn't it? The manual. Separate book, isn't it? Nah. No service history, guys. So that ain't good. At the end of the world. They never come with service history anyway. There. This is the back part of the bumper. I don't know if that's savable or not, really. Maybe. I'll have a look. Not worth it. They're all broken. Ain't worth keeping. Oh, that's the that's for the locking wheel nut. It's got locking wheel nuts. Yeah. It's not in here. It's not in there either. Okay. Oh, that's got to be changed as well. Get that for the breakers. Just electric switch. Easy done. Look at these little red things that go around. Someone's put these little red things around. This here. I don't know if I like them. I'm putting back to stock, really. Yeah. It's better. Just pulled it all off. Let's go around and look at the other side. Oh, could get lucky here. Never seen a bag like that though. Let me just check it. Yeah. Spot on. I'll just take them off anyway because I don't like leaving them on anymore. I'll just take them off and replace them with normal locking wheel nuts. So the mileage, as you can see, 82,481. 82,400. And what's that timing belt say? 80,645. So a new timing belt has just been done on this car. That's cool. I really like that. I really do like that. So, here we go. So this is our new little project, guys. Nice little Fiesta to get into. So there we go. Right, let me take the car in, and then I'll set you up, and then we'll start stripping it out. Let's get the bumper off at the back, because I've already got the new one. The new bumper's over here. As for that, front, that's all I've got to do. I've spoke to the paint guy, and I said to him, look, I've got a red car coming in, a Fiesta. Do you want me to get the parts and then bring you the parts and the car? And he was like, no, just bring me a sample or something to do with the paint thing, and I'll match it from that. I said, are you sure? He went, yeah, absolutely sure. I said, all right. Apart from that white one, he hasn't really let me down, you know what I mean, about that. So let's give him another chance. Let's give him another go, and let's see what he can do. But I'm not just quite sure, because even if you look at that colour there, I don't know if you can quite see that. It's always going to be a little bit different when it comes to the bumper anyway, because of plastic on metal. But you can just see the different, slight different in colour. But yeah, it's not major off, but it's there. But, yeah, let's see what you can do. That's the trouble, isn't it? When you're dealing with paint, and you're dealing with matching, and you're dealing with old cars, faded paint as well. It's just all those things. Yeah. But let's get you set up, I'll get the car in. Let's get this back bumper off. Let's start, you know, let's start on it now. So, see you in a sec, guys. Right, okay, guys, change of plan. Yeah, really sorry. Time's just sort of got away from me. I had so many other things going on. Like, I sold the van. I had a guy come over and he spent a good couple of hours here. I had to take the trailer back. I actually picked up the other one, the Vauxhall Corsa. It's in here. And I'll show you that, what he's done on another video. But yeah, I really wanted to get the car in. You know, I wanted to get it stripped down. I want to get the parts off. I want to start getting just getting into it. But it's one of them days, really. Like the guy that bought the van, he's left his car here as well, look. So that's sitting here. So yeah, like I really wanted to get it in so we can start just getting into it. But I just, like I said to you, I just ain't got the time today. So yeah, really apologise for it. That's all I can do. just got away from me a little bit. But so that's going to be at the end of today's video, guys. Really appreciate everyone's support. Checking out what's going on. Moving up. Just so busy today. I couldn't believe how busy I've been. Just selling bits as well. Like I've advertised for parts being sold. So. The other stereo from an old Fiesta, sold that for 25 quid. The van, obviously, he spent a couple of hours here just going through everything and checking everything and making sure that's all gone. And I got a great price for that van. Fantastic, exactly what I wanted. He tried to knock me down, as they always do, but you know what I mean? I had so many messages about that van. So many. Like, I literally posted it yesterday and I had about 30-40 messages to sort of say, can I come over? I want it. I'll give you, transfer it now. So I knew it was for the right money and I didn't want to overprice it. Just want to get rid. And that's exactly what happened, exactly what I got for it. So, sorry, blabbing on a little bit. So that's going to be it for today's video, guys. Hope you enjoyed today's video. Give the video a thumbs up. Really appreciate all the support, and we'll get on this one on Monday, and yeah, I'll see you on the next one. Thanks, guys.